Hello, I'm looking for Anne Shepherd's room.
Please sign the visitor's book. Are you a member of the family?
Yeah, you could say that.
Oh, she'll be pleased to have a visitor. No one ever comes to see her. With the Alzheimer's, she has trouble remembering things, but it'll still please her, you know. It's room 19 at the end of the corridor.
Thank you.
John Shepherd died 30 years ago. Hope his mother has all the answers to this puzzle. Room 19. Where is that? Room 19. Where is that?
Hello, Mrs. Shepherd.
Is it time for my pills already?
No, Mrs. Shepherd,
They're never on time with my pills. I don't know what they do here. In the other hospital, they were always on time. But here...
My name is Madison Page. I'm a journalist. I'd like to ask you some questions about your son.
I don't like this hospital. The food isn't very good, you know.
Your other son, Mrs. Shepherd, John's twin brother. What was his name?
What other son? I have no other son. I never had any children.
I know what happened at Carnaby Square. Do you remember?
Carnaby Square. I think I used to live there a long time ago. We didn't have much money at the time, you know. We had to make do with very little.
Do you remember John?
My Johnny. He is a good little boy, you know.
You had a son named John, and John had a twin brother.
Do you have my pills? It's time for my pills.
I think your son is in trouble, Mrs. Shepherd. He's done some terrible things. I need to find him. Do you understand?
Terrible things you're telling me. He never came to see me, can you believe it? In 10 years, never. No one forgets their mother, do they?
Try to remember, Mrs. Shepherd. John's twin brother was placed with a foster family after the accident. What was the name of the foster family?
I asked them for a television, you know. They said I didn't have enough money. It's a pity. I'm fond of television.
Mrs. Shepherd, your son may be linked to a series of murders. Perhaps you have some information that could help the investigation.
Are you a new nurse? Where are my pills?
All right, no point in wasting my time. I won't learn anything more by staying here.
I love origami, but that's not my favorite one.
It'd take days, if not longer, to find the name of the family that adopted her son. Sean Mars would be dead by then.
Oh, you know how to do these little dogs, too. My children loved origami. I taught them how to do it. John loved the little dogs. He always wanted to call them Max. Max, Max, Max. All dogs with the same name. I was wasting my time telling him they couldn't all have the same name. But he always wanted his paper dogs Max. It's funny, isn't it?
Seems to be working. She's remembering stuff. Gotta find something else to show her. This woman might be the origami killer's mother. Must be some way to get her to remember.
Did you make these origami figures?
My little paper animals. They played with them for hours. I showed my boys how to make them, you know.
Yes, your boys, Mrs. Shepherd. John and... what was your other son's name again?
My other son? I only had one son. My little Johnny.
All right, no point in wasting my time. I won't learn anything more by staying here. Alright, no point in wasting my time. I won't learn anything more by staying here. All right, no point in wasting my time. I won't learn anything more by staying here.
Does Mrs. Shepherd ever talk about her past?
It's not all very clear to her now. Sometimes she'll remember the oddest things, though. I suppose if she sees something that reminds her of her past.
I'm looking for her other son. He was adopted. I mean, he's probably changed his name. Is there any official documentation on Mrs. Shepherd?
No, there's nothing really. Nothing about her family. I guess if her son was adopted, then she's the only one who could tell you about that.
Does she get many visitors?
She's been here for 10 years and you're the first. Sometimes, if you show her things, it seems to trigger a memory from her past. You might get it to remember.
Thanks for the advice.
Show her things that take her back. Show her things that take her back. Show her things that take her back.
You don't seem to get many flowers, Mrs. Shepherd.
No, but I love them. My son knows that I love flowers. I know he'll bring me some.
Are these your children, Mrs. Shepherd? John and his brother? Is that them?
They're good little boys. Their father never looked after them. Always drinking. They didn't have an easy life, you know.
Her memory is coming back. Don't stop now. Just remember. Show her things that take her back.
What a lovely orchid. My sons loved orchids. We used to grow them in the back. When John died, I laid orchids on his grave. I cried when they told me. I'd already lost one of my children, and now they were taking away another one, you understand.
The foster family, Mrs. Shepherd. What was the name of the foster family that adopted John's brother?
They were really very nice people. I met them, you know. In the beginning, I used to go and see my little boy. And then I got sick and I couldn't go any longer. Perhaps he thought I'd forgotten him. He must have thought I didn't love him anymore.
His name, Mrs. Shepherd. What was his name?
But I loved him. If you only knew how much I missed him.
Please, Anne. His name. What was his name?
Come closer.
The last origami figure. The last trial.
The last trial. The last question. Are you prepared to give your life to save your sons? There is a deadly poison in this file. It will kill you in exactly 60 minutes. If you drink it, you will get the last letters of the address. You will have enough time to save your son and say goodbye to him, but then you will die. You can drink the file or decide to leave. The choice is yours.
Save Sean and die. Christ. He loses his father, but at least he's alive. Maybe it's the right thing to do. The cameras. He must be watching me. Kill myself to save Sean? That's ridiculous. I'll find some other way. I'm sure I can save him. I'll find you, Sean. I'll figure out a way and I'll come and get you, son.
I can't fight him!
Where are you, Sean? Where are you?
We've only got a few more hours left to save Sean Mars. There has to be a goddamn clue somewhere. It's probably staring me in the face. This kid's gonna die, and I'm going around in circles!
All packed up and ready to go?
What are you talking about?
The investigation's over. We know who did it. We no longer need your services anymore, Norman. So you can ride your files all the way back to Washington. I'd be lying if I said I was gonna miss you.
The investigation isn't over. You have absolutely nothing on Mars.
Mars is guilty. Case closed. Anyway, it's no concern of yours now. You're off the case. So pack up and fuck off.
Blake, you are an unbalanced, psychopathic asshole.
I'll take that as a compliment. Honestly, I don't give a shit what you think. I found the origami killer. Everyone's happy. End of story. Have a nice trip back, Norman.
The killer's name is here. Somewhere in this data. I just have to find it. Find it before it's too late.
Oh, one last thing, sir. You should be careful not to overindulge in you know what. It can be dangerous. Very dangerous. It'll end up killing you if you're not careful. That would be most unfortunate, sir.
Harry was in record mode when I was fighting with the killer. Perhaps there's something on him. The sword was already in Packer's office. It's got nothing to do with the killer. Gold watch. I'm sure I've seen this before somewhere. The watch they give for promotions to lieutenant. The killer is a cop. The gun the killer left at the Blue Lagoon. Perhaps there's some way of tracing its history.
impounded in a police case 5 years ago. The gun is still supposed to be in police custody. Who checked it out? If not a cop. Two receipts from the same gas station. Might be near the killer's home. The killer lives in this zone. 342 people live around there. Not good enough. Gotta find a means of identifying the killer more precisely. Ugh, that doesn't get us anywhere. Looks like the killer is a cop. Carter Blake! That would explain the dead-end investigation and his desire to frame Ethan Mars. A cop. There's only one cop in that geoprofiling zone. Gotcha. He owns a warehouse on the docks. If I'm wrong, Sean Mars is dead.
To get help fast. John's gonna drown. John's gonna drown. Mom's work is too far away. I'd never make it in time. Dad, I've gotta get Dad. He's the only one who can save John. Gotta move. This place is completely deserted. There's no one around to help. Someone, the water's still rising. John won't be able to hang on for long. Hold on, bro.
Dad, Dad, it's John. He fell into a pond.
Ah,
he's
get
coming.
Out of here, you little pet. Leave me alone.
Come, Dad. Come on, John's gonna die. John's gonna die.
Well, that'll be one less greedy mouth to feed, won't it? Go away.
Please, Dad, I'm begging you. John's gonna die. John's gonna die,
Dad.
What
did I tell you? Scrap.
John, I really tried, but he wouldn't come. Please don't die, John.
Scotty.
I should have informed the police. But I have no proof. Just the statement of an old woman who's lost her memory.
Nice you touch, girl. The Origami Killer's apartment. There must be something that'll tell me where Sean Mars is. Gotta be fast. He could come back anytime. I'll go through it, room by room. There's bound to be some kind of clue. Used to be a cop. Probably knew exactly how an investigation would be carried out. That's where the smell of burning comes from. Evidence going up in smoke. A cop's uniform. Always trust a cop. That's why children went with him. He was dressed as a cop. Shelby could come back at any moment. Shit, it needs a password. Got it. Max, the name John gave to his paper dogs when he was a child. What the hell is that? An address. It's gotta be where Sean Mars is. Hurry, there's no time to lose. This is where he cultivated the orchids that he left on the chest of his victims. Bingo! Come on, there still might be time to save Sean Mars.
So you found my little secret?
It's over, Scott. All those children killed just to find a father capable of saving his son?
Shut up! You don't understand.
There's one child left. There might still be time to save him. Let him go. Do what your father couldn't do.
Get in there.
I won't be able to breathe for much longer. A few minutes at most. Don't panic. Just stay calm and think. gonna lose consciousness in a few minutes. He sets fire to his apartment. He's trying to get rid of the proof and the only witness at the same time. I can't get out. I'm gonna die, and there'll be no one to save Sean. I might still have a chance. If I could just get out of the apartment. Think, man, think. I gotta find some way to protect myself from the heat and smoke. Trying to get out the window, the jump would kill me. The apartment is already in flames. I gotta move fast if I want to get it alive. It's way too high. I'll kill myself if I jump. I gotta find something else. There's got to be a way out of the apartment.
I know where Sean is. I've got to tell Ethan. It's Madison. I know where Sean is. He's at 852 Theodore Roosevelt Road. He's still alive. You can still save him.
I'm on my way.
Be careful, Ethan. The killer's still out there.
No one's gonna stop me from saving my son.
I hope it's not too late.
Sean! Sean!
I've been looking for a long, long time. Looking for a father that would be able to do what mine could not do. Sacrifice himself in order to save his son. Oh, I searched, searched, searched. And then I remembered you.
Just to find a father capable of saving his son.
Just to find a father? Do you have any idea how it feels to be a worthless nothing in your father's eyes? Believe me, I've suffered just as much as my victims.
I finished your damn trials. Now give me back my son!
He's there. All you have to do is open that grave.
I'll get you out of there, Sean.
Are the snipers in position?
Yes, Lieutenant. They're ready on your command.
Perfect. He won't get away this time. We'll gun him down as soon as he shows his face. Hey! You there! What are you doing?
Lieutenant, my name is Madison Page. I'm a journalist. I have proof that Ethan Mars is innocent. He's not the origami
Ash,
killer.
What is a journalist doing here? I thought I told everybody to keep their mouths shut. Now get her out of here. I don't want her getting in the way.
Okay, Lieutenant. All right, come on.
You're about to make a terrible mistake, Lieutenant. Ethan Mars is innocent. I can prove it.
Don't leave me. Sean, oh, thought you were gone.
Dad, I knew you would come and save me.
Ash, get her out of my face.
Mars didn't do it, for Christ's sakes. He's innocent.
Hey, what are you doing?
Sorry I didn't trust you. I was only thinking about Sean, and I thought...
That's okay. The only thing that matters is that you saved your son.
General relief this morning when the police announced that they had found Sean Mars alive more than 4 days.